And they also had gave me a defective mic. Did you notice that? My mic was defective within the room.
The debate was over, but Donald Trump was still on the defensive. For an hour and a half, presidential candidate Hillary Clinton and Trump went toe-to-toe at the first presidential debate here at the Hofstra University in Long Island, New York. At the beginning of the debate, Trump appeared calm and collected, hitting Clinton heavily on trade and TPP, and Trump was very effective. About 20 minutes into the debate, Clinton began driving the conversation. Donald Trump took the bait and went on defensive mode.
Or maybe he doesn't want the American people, all of you watching tonight, to know that he's paid nothing in federal taxes.
I will release my tax returns against my lawyer's wishes when she releases her 33,000 emails that have been deleted. As soon as she releases them, I will release my tax returns.
Trump also interrupted Clinton about 25 times during the debate, but Clinton seemed unfazed. Critics believe Clinton handled race relations, the birther issue lie, and even the stamina issue well. Clinton showed knowledge of issues and command of policy, while debate watchers said Trump offered no specifics.
The battle at Hofstra is dubbed as a Super Bowl of debates, with more than 100 million expected viewers. But the question is, will it change the minds of voters?
People are undecided. It may give everybody a better perspective of who is going to be the better president.
A CNN poll showed 62% of viewers thought Clinton won the debate, while 27% said Trump was victorious. After tonight, Trump may have not lost any supporters, but the question is, did he gain any? Trump and Clinton's next face-off is set on October 9 at the Washington University in St. Louis, Missouri. It will be moderated by CNN's Anderson Cooper and ABC News' Martha Raddatz. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, Hempstead, New York.